40 years ago, Hong Kong produced up to 35% of the food the city consumed. But as its economy diversified, agriculture took a backseat. Today, the city produces only about 1.6% of the vegetables it consumes.
For the vegetable supply, Shanghai can provide 40%. So Beijing is a little bit less than 10%, but they have a goal to achieve 20%. So for Guangzhou, it's nearly 100%. We don't really have a policy of keeping a self-sustained food supply.
咁呢一個問題就係話點解我哋咁被動呢?
Putting all our eggs in one basket is never a good strategy because we are exposing ourselves to a lot of risk. Diversifying our food supply chain is one way of managing that risk.
This month on Hong Kong Inquirer, we're taking a look at the sharp decline of local farm produce. How does it impact the city and what can we do to secure a more robust food system?
Hong Kong spends nearly 5.26% of its GDP just on purchasing food to feed its residents. Chinese mainland services a bulk of its fresh food needs. Nearly 94% of Hong Kong's fresh pork, 100% fresh beef, 92% vegetables, and 66% eggs come from the mainland. Substantial amount of the frozen meat is imported from Brazil, Australia, United States, and New Zealand. Seafood and fresh fruits and vegetables come from Thailand, Indonesia, Philippines, and Norway.
In Hong Kong, food is not cheap, and locally produced food, especially organic, is even costlier. Take this organic melon, for example. I paid nearly $12 for this. But despite high price, demand for local produce has been growing in Hong Kong. Why?
它的味道是鮮甜一點的,是啊,感覺是好吃一點.
Because it's picked before it's ready, whereas if it's picked here, it's picked this morning and then I get it today. So it means all of the nutrition is much more powerful.
現在在香港的市民,他們因為疫情的影響,更加注重健康。 去了解多啲佢哋食緊用緊嘅嘢，究竟係唔係一啲安全嘅嘢？需要一啲真正安全食品嘅人，一日多過一日。
That's Wang Jinming. He grew up in local farms around Hong Kong, and for nearly 16 years now has been managing this farm near the border with Shenzhen. He uses aquaponic farming that involves farming fish and vegetables together. Wong says he uses natural resources rather than pesticides, and that helps create a circular eco-farming system. He says all these crayfish here have already been sold in advance for about 130 Hong Kong dollars apiece. He hopes to demonstrate that, with the right methods, Hong Kong can produce food that can match the high-quality imported products.
我最初是因為這件事而做的，給一些需要武農藥食品的人去吃，因為這些長期病患者、敏感病患者，或者一些老人家，或者一些癌症病患者，他需要有一些安全食品去吃。 在這段期間,我們收到很多不同的Facebook 上面問我們,直接打電話來,直接走進我們的農莊都有的。現在最多來找我們的是什麼呢? 就是一些高質素的餐廳。他們希望可以用到一些本土化、低碳、又可以安全地食用。 而那個質量又要符合到他們高級餐廳的要求，往往他們進來就會試過我們的產品，見到我們所用的材料和方式之後，他們都很想跟我們訂貨。反而在這個過程裡面，我是生產不到那麼多貨品去供應給他們。其實食物就是我們最重要的生存能力。我都覺得任何一個地區，它一定要有兩樣東西的，生產的知識技術。 和生產的空間，你都需要依然保持到一定程度的。
to those pushing for Hong Kong to increase local food supply, it's not only about health, but also about a more resilient food system. In 2010, Hong Kong ranked the ninth among 80 regions on global financial firm Nomura's Food Vulnerability Index.
So a lot of people, when they think about food security, they confuse it with food safety, thinking, oh, it's a question of health and nutrition, whether my food has excessive chemical insecticides or fungicides. Food security really looks at the whole food supply chain.
That's Dr. Daisy Tam of the Hong Kong Baptist University. She teaches urban food systems and practices with a focus on food security.
So food security is defined as when all people at all times have safe and secure access to food to sustain a healthy living daily life. That includes three different indicators, availability, access, and use. So when we engage in an industrialized food production system, we're exposing ourselves to market fluctuations, which creates vulnerabilities in our food supply system. COVID has shown us very clearly that this is the case. In the beginning, when people were panic buying, the supplies dropped, there were literally nothing on the shelves.
Hong Kong is one of the most densely populated cities in the world. Still, only about less than 30% of the territory is built up. About 50 square kilometers, or nearly 4.5% of the land, is under agricultural use.
Well, I guess the land supply is one of the major issues. Because if you want to have a market share, you need to have a scale. So if you don't have land, you won't have scale.
That's Professor Lam Hon Ming from the Chinese University of Hong Kong. He specializes in climate smart and sustainable agriculture, as well as plant and agricultural biotechnology.
So even the farmer wants to do a longer term investment in a farm, they need to own the land first. But the profits they can make, even though they are owner, this is more profitable if some developer choose the land to develop into real estate than growing plants for selling to the market.
香港的農地有很多，可以使用的農地仲有很多。而家喺唔同嘅地區都依然有好多嘅土地閒置咗喺度嘅。嚟到呢度嘅時候呢，咁我發覺呢度有好多唔同嘅空地啦，有好多嘅丟棄咗嘅魚塘啦。咁我就慢慢慢慢由萬零尺嘅地方做到而家十幾廿萬尺。
Land is in short supply, and yet of the 50 square kilometers available, only about 7.1 square kilometers is being used, leaving nearly 80% of the land sitting idle. Many owners have either kept their land idle for more profitable development or say it is too polluted to be used for agriculture. Another limitation is a lack of agriculture knowledge and manpower. Hong Kong now has only about 4,300 farmers working at 2,500 farms. That's 0.1% of the city's total workforce.
很多的人因為比較容易找到一兩萬元的人工，就出了去打工，放棄了我們的土地。在那個階段裡面，那個技術流失了。現在在 現時近期很多人走入來做農業，有一種揸住好多錢去搞一個農莊，但係佢要請唔同嘅人去做嘅時候，請唔到技術人員。有一啲人佢好有心做，佢有能力去做，但係冇資金去發展。喺呢兩者之間咧，其實如果佢哋溝通得好嘅話，可以將農業發展得相對理想嘅。
With limited land and workforce, Professor Lam suggests Hong Kong should also tap into agricultural technology.
How about other urban agricultural practice? For example, vertical agriculture, hydroponics, those are new technology. Can we make better use of the roof? Now, in the past, people say no because it's too heavy. But now there are some medium for cultivation. That's lightweight, so make it possible. Korea has a law enabling the a city park to be converted partially into farm, so that the community, when they enter the city park, they can grow some vegetables together. Will it be possible?
And with the indoor hydroponic system, there's no pollution from air, soil, and also water. You will not add in unnecessary additive, like a lot of the chemicals, into the system.
That's Dr. Henry Lam, founder and CEO of GrowGreen, a startup at Hong Kong Science Park that's developing smart home-based planting systems using a refrigerator-like auto-controlled grower.
We can also expand the technology like Aspara into vertical farming by going into the industrial estates, making growing vegetables like a farm. Then you do not only help to reduce the food safety issue and also help to support the food supply of Hong Kong as well.
If we have a bigger scale, we can join this technology together with other technologies such as the artificial intelligence and big data. Because in China, I think when they have a large scale hydroponic systems, all the growth data can be collected and centralized. By an AI system, they can optimize the cultivation method.
Chinese mainland has a mandatory vegetable basket policy for non-green food supply. It requires each region to maintain self-sustaining non-green food supply within its territories. Beijing targets to increase its local vegetable supply to 20% by 2025, whereas Shanghai already grows locally about 40% of its vegetable requirement.
I think Hong Kong would benefit from setting a target of having a minimal supply of food for its own citizens.
香港政府亦都需要將諗辦法將呢啲閒置嘅土地拎翻出嚟俾農業部分嘅人去使用，唔係再係做一個細細嘅一個農業園。
Some argue that in a city where land is scarce, we should focus on housing and keep importing food as is economical. But some others believe that boosting local food supply would not only benefit the environment, people's health, but also help build harmonious communities. What do you think about the issue? Please drop a comment below and don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon. We'll be bringing you new inquiries every month here in Hong Kong.